thinks there's always tomorrow. I miss your touch on nights when I'm hollow. I know you crossed a bridge that I can't follow. Good morning and welcome back to my channel. It is the 28th of August today, which means that we are 1 week out from show day. Cannot believe I'm even saying that. So yeah, here we are. The glow up does actually start today. I'm getting my nails done, mainly because my nail tech won't be here any closer to the show, so I need to get them done, and she's amazing and I don't trust anyone else. So cardio first meal in, and then I will be off to go and get my nails done. So yeah, I will see you at cardio. Let's fast forward just a few hours. Cardio ticked off, checked in this morning as you guys saw, and the feedback from Vicky was we're looking a little bit flat this morning, but not to worry, it doesn't really matter. I have to check in now daily, and I will be checking in later on at about 5 p.m. since this is the time that I will most likely be on stage on Sunday. It's really important that we kind of know how I look, how I digest and respond to food at that certain time. So I've just actually come back from my girl Laura's. We went for an ombre with a silver top coat, and I just sat down for the second coffee of the day, and I just wanted to say this. I know I said that the caramel pecan is good, but this is even better. So second coffee of the day is better than the first. I'm now just going to actually get myself ready for the gym. No work today. Today is a Saturday. I have got a few bits and pieces to get sorted for show next weekend. I need to write some lists about what I need to pack, what I need to do. Basically, I just need to plan the next kind of 4 or 5 days out. I'm probably not going to take you guys through that session, only because I wanted to keep this video to a peak week video, and you guys know how I train, you guys know what I do. Update in terms of training, nothing has changed. Training with the same intensity. However, like I kind of covered a few weeks ago, I am just doing one working set on the big presses, the big squats, and any of the kind of hinging or deadlift movements. We're looking quite flat, to be honest. Not much roundness at all. I just can't believe we're here. Leave it. final bit. Excuse my hair, I'm just about to have my one and only lot of carbohydrates today, and remember that I hadn't updated you guys. So about 3 days ago I checked in and my carbohydrates from post-workout have been completely removed, so now my only carbohydrates are pre-training, which I'm about to have now. This is how I'm looking without any carbs in me. Yeah. Interesting. I'm now just in the one meal. Hence why I probably feel a bit like ass over this last few days. But final push, I'm here for it. And that is training all ticked off. Feel very tired today. Quite hungry as well. So it actually makes me laugh, this meal. I'm actually going to show you my post-workout meal. Very underwhelming. Don't laugh. It is what it is. It really is what it is. A very sorry looking 130 grams of cooked chicken and 10 grams of nut butter, and that is it. Salt and a little bit of ketchup as normal. My carbs, like I said earlier, have been removed. My carbs have now completely gone from my post-workout. And the reason for this is that as soon as insulin is spiked on the intake of carbohydrates, fat loss and the mobilization of those fat cells is prohibited, is stopped. So
yeah, we're not having any carbs. I would much rather stand on stage, know that we pushed for more condition, than got up there and gone, nah, I wish I'd have done more, or wish we'd have pushed more. Of course, it's up to Vicky, and I just follow orders, but yeah, I don't really care. But it just looks very sorry, so.
So just before I jump in the shower, just thought I would show you what it is that I'm using to exfoliate my skin. I just picked this up from TK Maxx about 2 weeks ago now, and you don't have to spend a fortune on these things. This was £5 and this is a huge tub. So now that we are in peak week, I will be using this daily. I've been using this since I was 3 weeks out, like every other day. It will basically just get off all of the dead skin that's on top of your skin, obviously, and it will just mean that the tan goes on better, and then you won't have like patchy horrible tan. So yeah, make sure that if you've never competed before that you do your skin prep, because on stage the last thing you want is to have a nasty tan. Scrub your skin. That is skin prep all done, and I'm now bathed in moisturizer. I'm just going to head out and finish my steps for the rest of the day. I basically just live in Louis jumpers, leggings, and slides, of course. I am very tired today, very, very tired. I'm just awaiting feedback from Vicky. I had a PM post-workout kind of check-in with her. So yeah. Hopefully it'll be something good, because I send pictures off at the moment and I just kind of sit there and think, oh my god, I'm not gonna be ready, or genuinely I'm just very anxious to like get feedback back. But I just think it's the nature of this point in prep, and you just have to keep going. Before I head out, it's time for a Pepsi Max. It tastes so good. Steps, come back, chill the hell out, and get some feedback from Vic. Fingers crossed it's good. What I am doing is writing a little bit of a list of stuff that I need to pack. I'm taking 2 bags with me, so I just wanted to know what's going to go where. And I will tick this off, and then I will tick it off again, just to make sure I have absolutely everything. Yes, that does say P cups. Girls, if you know, you know. Obviously, when you're tanned, you cannot just use the toilet like normal. You don't want to ruin your tan. So a few bits and pieces there. I'm going to go through this in a little bit more detail when I actually pack my stuff. I thought I'd just write in this really cute little notebook. So fast forward a few hours later, I have done everything I've needed to do. It's now just going up to 6 o'clock. I actually booked some cinema tickets to go and watch a film. I will be going on my own, because I love being on my own. And it'd be nice to kind of have to turn my phone off for a few hours. I've just done an evening, late afternoon check-in for Vicky. I will pop the pictures here. I'm not really showing anything on Instagram during this peak week, but I appreciate this video will be out a little bit later. I'm just going to bring a meal with me, and a Pepsi Max, of course. I can't even remember the name of the film I'm going to see, but it's a rest day, and I want to make sure I'm really relaxed. My resting heart rate has fallen to an average of 35 beats a minute, and this is why I'm so cold, because my heart is just like chilling. So I will catch up with you guys a little bit later. In terms of anything that's changed in my peak week so far, all of my post-workout cardio is now gone. No change to diet as of yet, so I'm still running that same meal plan that I have been now for a few weeks.
One very sorry looking meal and a Pepsi,
and that is what I'm going to see.
Alexa, volume down. It is now Tuesday of peak week. I've checked in again this morning. Cardio is done.
I actually dropped a pound overnight since reduction in cardio, reduction in steps, and I am feeling very tight actually, hence the weight drop. Had a wicked sleep, enjoyed myself at the cinema last night, managed not to fall asleep, even though I'm a very old person in a young person's body and I tend to fall asleep all of the time. Today is pull. It's my final pull session. I'm actually going to be going back to Phoenix Bryson today just for a change of scenery. Yeah, so that should be good. I have a few bits of work to do this morning. You saw yesterday that I wrote out some lists. I need to go shopping and get some bits on those lists, and just make a start with packing because I really do not enjoy doing things last minute. No changes to food as of yet. We are just kind of running off of the drop in expenditure for now. My legs look much tighter than they did yesterday. I'm starting to see a little bit of detail in my glutes, hamstrings, and quads. And this is of course because I'm not hammering away on the Stairmaster. There's not all of that kind of blurred look that you get when you spend all of your time doing that. So that is the update so far. We have Wednesday, Thursday at home. I will be back with Louis on Friday and Saturday, and we will be traveling down to up to, I don't even know. I'm used to saying down because I used to live in the Midlands, but we're going up this time to Surrey for the show, which is all very exciting. So I've been prepping my skin as normal. I'm just about to eat my first meal of the day and crack on with some work before pool later. Good morning, it is officially the 2nd of September, which means I'm 3 days out. I checked in this morning, actually had a FaceTime kind of check-in with Vicky, mainly because the lighting doesn't really reflect how I look and we both know this. So cardio has now been pulled down to 220 calories. So that usually takes about 20 minutes to do on the bike. So nothing really now compared to the 75 minutes I was doing. And basically we are just rolling into the show this weekend. We're not really going to be doing much of a load or anything, mainly because I need to be leaner for Two Bros, which is in 2 weeks. So just off to get some food now, and then we will be running normal rest and training day macros for the remainder of the week. So I thought I would take you guys through what it is that I'm taking with me to the show. I've got some stuff here. Sliders, really important, because obviously you don't want to be prancing around backstage in your heels because it's going to make you feel tired. Also, you're more likely to fall over, which is not what we want. Some gym wear so that I can be comfortable, because obviously I'm not going to be in my bikini all day. I have what it is that I'm going to wear for my tan. Now it's important that you don't wear anything with cuffs or kind of thick drawstring waistbands, as that will potentially damage the tan. I have these like cotton trousers. They're just like loose fitting, really comfortable. I have a long sleeve t-shirt. It's a size small, so it's quite big. It's a men's small, so it's quite loose fitting and big on me. It's not fitted, it's not like a muscle top or anything. And then in case it is very cold, which most likely it will be, I have a big jumper that I can throw on over the top as well. But again, because this is oversized on me, the cuffs are not gonna like ruin my tan or anything. So I've got is some bedding we will use in the Airbnb. Now obviously you don't want to get tan on the Airbnb fitted sheets or duvet or anything like that, because they will probably charge you. So I just have a duvet set and then a fitted sheet as well, just to protect myself. And I will obviously after this show I'll wash them and then I'll take them to all of my other shows this year as well. Don't forget as well that when you're out of your bikini you need underwear. Don't forget that, because, well, unless you like going commando, I'm not a fan. So that is what I'm bringing in terms of clothes. I'm not actually going to be eating out after this show. Now this is because I have another show
2 weeks later, and I need to be coming in a little bit tighter. So obviously if you are going out for a meal after your show or something like that, then it would be a good idea to bring some nice normal people clothes. I haven't packed my bikini yet, and this is because I've been checking in wearing it for the last few days. I do have my jewellery. Now, I don't have my ears pierced. That is not an issue at all. These little girls, if you don't have your ears pierced, which to be honest, most people do, we can obviously still have jewellery, and they're really good. They don't ping off or anything like that. So I have thinner bracelet. I have a thicker one. Also a hat, because those that know me know my head gets very cold, so that is an essential for me.
I was just writing out my logbook, and writing 3 days out at the top of my page is very, very surreal. I remember writing 120 days out at one point, and just that kind of feeling of prep and like show day is never going to come around. Because it always kind of feels so distant, and now here we are. But today is my last proper session. I have a pump session to do tomorrow. Normal session today. Intensity and volume as it is. I have a few bits to do this afternoon, but just thought I would show you. I picked these up. The hair salon. It's like an instant kind of like liquid shine to put on my hair to make it super glossy and stay. Some lashes. I get my makeup done, so I just needed to make sure I had some strip lashes. Now, I got asked the other day whether I get my eyelashes done, as in like extensions. I used to get them done all the time, but the reason I'm not getting them done for shows is because I have multiple shows this year. I know they're gonna start falling out, and I can't really be bothered to get them in filled like 3 times. So it's far easier, I think, to just get strip lashes, and then you can just remove them, and obviously you can reuse them. We've now taken cardio down in the mornings to just 20 minutes. No cardio post-workout, which is gonna feel really weird. So yeah, just going in to train today. Good morning, it is now Friday, which means I am 1 and a bit days out. I checked in with Vicky this morning. We had a little bit of a FaceTime. Cardio was out this morning, and I also have some extra food today. So I'm having my normal bacon medallions and egg whites. I'm also having 100 grams of blueberries and 2 rice cakes. So nothing massive. I also have more carbs in my pre-workout meal, and I also have them in my post and post and the meal after that as well. Very exciting stuff. I'm just going to eat this, finish packing. After my pump session, I will be traveling, so I will take you guys along with me. I'm very tired. I am doing the do, which is wrapped up in a blanket, watching YouTube videos I've already watched before. Haven't been as cold this prep as I was in 2019. Don't really know why, but this peak week I've just like frozen. So it is now 9:24. Carolina is coming around to help me shave my back, because let's be honest, I can't reach my back to shave it, and all the hair has to be gone, because we want a seamless tan and all of that kind of thing. So once we have done that, then I will be having my pre-workout meal and heading straight to the gym across the road to do my pump session, which I will probably record, to be honest, because it's not going to take me long anyway. I thought I would pick up the camera and just let you guys kind of know. The peak week isn't really that interesting or exciting. I feel quite rough. Not rough, but tired, hungry and cold, more so than I have for most of this prep, but the excitement and the anticipation to get on stage is definitely there. So yeah, and I recall the past real vaguely. I remember everything they'd say. Maybe thought that I was crazy, thinking that one day they'd
see my name. Love being a loner, always moving closer. Knew exactly what I wanted to have. Fear of growing older, chip all on my shoulder. Told myself I'm never looking back. And now I'm cold and dissonant. I'm losing my innocence, and you don't know my intent. And now you better back down, cause I'm coming for.
And there we go, that is everything packed for the weekend. We are now on the road. All very, very exciting. I am ready. I am just heading off to the train station now. Bikini, robe, heels. I have those with me. Those are obviously the main things. I will see you guys on the way. So we made it all the way to Surrey, and we have kind of settled into the little Airbnb. It's very cute, so I thought I would just do a little bit of a tour. So come in, and we got a fully kitted out kitchen with little tiny hob, microwave, which is the essential, and all of the food and all of this wine that they left for us, which I will mainly not be having. These amazing lemon drizzle cookies that have nearly all gone. Lol, wasn't me. So maybe I'll get to try one of those after the show. Bar stuff and food. Little downstairs area is very cute. The TV. And then bathroom. Nice shower. And yeah, just enough room. These very extreme stairs. And then a lovely little bedroom, which is very sweet. A dressing table, some skylights, tripod, laptop, bikini stuff, another mirror, another window, and then just lots of space really.
Whoa, 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 what are you doing?
I'm trying to be a...
Why?
Because they're easy. Oh, jeez. You kicked the damn thing over.
I want to get my leg back in there now.
As if.
You're fucked! No, you know. She's gone. She... No, you don't you dare put her back! Yeah! Oh, I need to.
Fuck you! You are... That's such a shit play.
Oh, that's cool. Nice one! No!
You're such an arsehole. Fuck you up. Alright, I'm gonna get your dinner. It's now Saturday, which means that I'm competing tomorrow, which is very, very exciting. I just wanted to kind of sign off the vlog. Last night we went food shopping, as you saw, and then I came back, checked in with Vicky again, in like on a FaceTime kind of thing. So that was really good. She's very happy. I have a different kind of meal plan today. It's very similar. We're not really running that many carbohydrates, more than we were previously, but nothing crazy. And I will be drinking normal amounts of water, a little bit extra, about 500 ml extra. So I'm doing four of these today. 600 ml, 6 liters total. The plan of action today is to rest. I will be editing this video, so that's going to keep me busy. I have a little bit of client work to do. I have a setup to do, and then I will actually be seeing my parents, which I'm super, super excited for. It's been 5.5 months since I've seen them, so that'll be really nice. I'm just generally just chilling out with Louis. I haven't really seen him that much over the last few weeks. So yeah, but the work is done. I have my tan today at 5:45, but I'm not gonna record that because obviously I want this to be out in time before show day. Thank you everyone for all of the kind of the messages I've already received over the last few days. It doesn't go unnoticed. I do really appreciate it. Now it's just time to enjoy it. The work is done. I feel very calm, very relaxed. Yeah, it's been a completely different prep for me, and I've enjoyed it so much. I really have. But this is just show number 1 of 4, so from here we do need to move forward. We do need to continue to push for some more condition. I'm just looking forward to being up there more than anything. I love being on stage. I'm going to leave this video here. Yeah, thank you ever so much for everyone that's watched this series so far. Please do like, comment and subscribe to my channel, as it really does help me out. Please share this video. I hope that you've enjoyed seeing what a peak week looks like, and I will see you in my show day vlog.